Okay, hi there. We are going to see how this goes today. You'll be seeing closer up of the painting. I tried to fix it to where it wasn't so far away. And so this is Color Song Part 2. Before we get started, I want to show you, and I kind of showed this in the last art video when I showed the paints I was using and how to scrape the paint off the glass palette. But what I did is I ended up putting all the leftover paint on this one. This is that paper that I had prepped. And then even today when I mixed paints, I just put some over it. So it has some wet paint in it. And we're gonna proceed with this. Again, we have no idea what's gonna happen, but I'll be working on all three now and seeing what we can get done today. So, I'm going to use a brush, and I'm gonna use this thing. This is a palette knife that I had used to scrape into, and I'll do that along the way too. But I'm gonna go ahead and just get started and just laying down some paint. I mixed some light colors, I mixed some grays. I like gray. And even before I got started, I kind of put some water with some of this charcoal or graphite that I'd put on, and you can see how it makes it darker, and it really kind of comes out cool if you wet it. So I'm gonna kind of wet some of that. Even if it drips down, that's fine. But I had wet some of this earlier and it kind of made a gray, so I like that process. I think I'll do that to this one a little bit also before we get started on that one, and just kind of wet down some of those. See how that does? It makes it kind of a gray, and I don't know if you can see that, how it makes it a darker mark. I like doing marks, and then sometimes doing that kind of thing even brings out some grays and other marks. So there we go. All right. All right, this is on that pink and purple, teal, little yellow color palette. So we'll try to kind of stay with that. I'm gonna put down some of the darker purple again, just to give it a little contrast. Kind of go in some of these areas that I hadn't painted yet. And maybe a little bit of that dark magenta. And I'm not even washing my brush. I'm going into a darker, this is cerulean blue that I did not put on it last time. And I like cerulean blue with it too, so we'll just kind of put some of that, and also some of the teal that we had put down before. You can kind of see we're filling in some of those white areas as we go along. And I'm going to bring in some really, really light yellow in places. Not that yellow, but a different yellow. When you mix the yellow and the teal, you get a little bit of a greenish value, which is kind of cool. I'm also going to bring in some of this gray that I made. I mixed all kinds of colors in it. I don't even remember what all colors I had in it. I have a lighter gray that I made. Thank you. again, this is just to create that grid effect. I want to kind of let that one pause and work on this next one. Hope you can see it better this time. Okay, on this one, I'm going to go back into some of that dark blue. This is ultramarine blue. And this is the Payne's gray, which is kind of like a really dark blue gray. And I didn't even, again, wash my brush. I just put it back in it. And then this really dark burnt orange that I put down the other day. I really like that with the blue. You mix it with the blue, creates a really dark color. I'm gonna go back in with some of that light. I made up another coral. It may not be the same color. When I mix colors, they may not be the same, but it's a little lighter, so it's kind of a cool thing. And then I made a coral gray, if that makes any sense. You can hear David Carr in the background, DavidCarrJr.com. All right, I'm gonna go in again with some carbon black. We're gonna let that one sit for a little bit. And this one, I just tried to tape it on the back with some of this, just to kind of roll it backwards and tape it, and it didn't hold it. So I'm having to kind of try this route on this one. And since I've got it in black, I'm gonna put some more black in this. I normally don't just mix white and black to create a gray, but since I had black in it, I put it a little bit in the white to create a lighter gray. And I may have kind of a gray area as an outer border, who knows. I really like gray. Alright, we're going to go with, since we have gray, I'm going to kind of mix it in some of the lighter purple, and it kind of needs to grade down purple. This is going to look different, I know, when we get done, so just know that right now we're playing. Alright, I'm going to add on this one, I'm going to add some of that yellow back into it. I'm gonna add some white. It's kind of mixed in with all these other colors. It's not exactly white, but alright, we're going to let that one pause. You see how different that's looking now? Oops. It just doesn't want to stay. I'll keep trying with that one. Okay. I'm going to bring some of the black into this one too. Thank you. You can see we're slowly kind of filling in some of the areas. I don't know what I'll do with that, but that's kind of what I'm doing right now. It's what feels right. Just some of this light gray. Sorry, I forget to tell you what I'm doing. I'm putting some really light teal and kind of get caught up with what I'm doing and not talk, so that's probably fine for you. You don't hear me talk, just watch me paint. A little different value that I'm putting in some of these areas. Thank you. This may end up being a lot of dabs, but just think of it again as one note at a time with color, with songs and with the colors. All right, I'm gonna let that one pause. You can see that one. Try to show it to you up close as much as I can. And we'll work on the next one a little bit more. Maybe a little bit longer video than the last one, but that's okay. I wanted to get a little bit further along with it. when you paint, you may not know what colors you're going to use. It's just whatever feels right when you pick it up on your brush and put it on the canvas. And it's like I really didn't have a plan. So when I mix, you see sometimes I have different colors on the brush, so it may be multicolored when it comes off, which is kind of cool. Do the same to this one. Thank you. there's that one. We're gonna stop. I'll show it to you real close. Hopefully we can keep going. We'll be putting a lot more layers on them and see where they end up, but I'm kind of enjoying this. This is just a lot of little notes, so to speak, color notes. And this one, of course, we'll see what it looks like next time. And I think I'll start another one of these with the leftover paints from today. So we might have four that we're working on next time. Sorry it's so long, but I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click like and hit the subscribe button so you can be notified of my new videos as I publish them. I have chemo tomorrow, so it may be a while before I publish another one. And I've really, really enjoyed painting after having 7 months of not painting. This has been so much fun and therapy for me. So I just appreciate all of you. I hit over 150 subscribers on my YouTube channel. I couldn't believe it. Thank y'all so much for watching my videos and subscribing and liking what I post. Thank you so much. See you next time. Bye-bye.